So my name is Sarah Tuttleton-Arron, and I'm a dermatologist. I am the Associate Director of the Dermatologic Surgery and Laser Center at the University of California, San Francisco, and I run the high-risk skin cancer program, which is a combined clinic and research laboratory focused on skin cancer in immunosuppressed patients. So I've always really liked science. In elementary school, I liked the natural world, the animals that we had in science class, learning about the trees in the park. I just thought that was a very interesting topic. And as I grew older, I started taking classes like biology and chemistry. And one of the things I was really impressed by was just the very elegant logic of the concepts we were learning. And in high school and even in college, you're spending a lot of time learning about the what of science, but what really drew me into it was starting to ask questions about why the world is the way it is, why disease happens to people, and not only what's going on, but the questions that come out of that. And at a certain point in my studies, I started hitting upon questions that people didn't have answers to, and that's when I discovered that what a scientist really does is tries to find answers to questions that people haven't looked at before. So when I decided to go to medical school, I was interested in HIV. This was an epidemic where I grew up in the West Village of New York City, and it was something people didn't know a lot of answers about. And during the course of my medical studies, doing the MD and then doing a PhD in HIV virology, a lot changed in the political landscape. A lot more was known about HIV. I was still very interested in infectious disease, but what I discovered on seeing patients and treating patients was that dermatology appealed to me even more because there was this visual aspect to it. You could see what was going on with the patient. And then there was this technical aspect to the procedures that dermatologists do that really appealed to my sense of wanting to get in there with my hands and really treat disease actively. So I went towards dermatology and am still interested in viruses and viruses that cause skin disease. So I live in San Francisco, which is the second greatest city in the world.
What's better?
I grew up in New York. So once a New Yorker, always a New Yorker. But I came out to San Francisco for my training. Love it here. The weather is wonderful year-round, so we spend a lot of time outdoors. I have two kids and a dog, so we spend a lot of weekends at the beach, hiking in the mountains. So the thing I love about being a physician scientist is that every day is a little bit different. I spend about half my time seeing patients and doing a kind of surgery called Mohs micrographic surgery. And this is a surgical procedure for removal of skin cancer, primarily skin cancers on the face and on the head and neck. And the way Mohs surgery works is that I go in, I see the patient, I put in a little bit of local anesthesia, and then I cut around just the area of skin cancer that we see on the skin. And then we put a temporary bandage on the patient. And while they wait, I take that piece of tissue into the lab across the hall, where my technicians will actually cut slides and prepare histology for me to look at under the microscope. So when I look under the scope, I'm able to see if I've got the entire cancer out or if there are any cancer cells left remaining. And if there are cancer cells there, I go back to the patient. I say, we need to take a little bit more, maybe only between 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock, or maybe deeper but not any wider, and we repeat that process. And so we repeat that process during the day as many times as we need to until we have 100% clear tumor margins. And then in the second half of the procedure, what I do is I talk to the patient about what kind of reconstruction would be most functionally appropriate and most aesthetically pleasing, and we stitch the patient up. So we have a 98% cure rate with this procedure, and as somebody who likes to work with my hands and with my eyes, it's really fun to do, and it's also really satisfying to know I can have 8 to 10 patients with cancer in the morning, and by the end of the day, I've cured 8 cancers. And I might do that 2 days a week or 3 days a week, and then on the other days, I come into the research laboratory where I have a totally different set of tasks. I run a research lab of about 5 or 6 people. And we are interested in studying what causes these skin cancers that I'm seeing in my patients. And so among the things we do are we take excess tissue from the surgery, we bring it back to the lab, and we do molecular studies on it. We look at the DNA of that tumor to see what mutations are there that might be causing that normal cell to become a cancerous cell. We look at ways that sunlight or ultraviolet radiation actually stimulate cancer in the skin. And then we also try and determine by looking at large populations of patients who is going to be at highest risk. Can we figure out what patient needs to be seen for screening sooner? Who's going to get cancer? Or if someone has cancer, are they going to have a bad outcome or will they be easily cured? T1 translational research really describes going from the bedside, where you're working with a patient, to the bench, where you're doing molecular biology or cellular biology or some basic science research on that disease. And I like to adhere to what we call the handshake rule, which is that I do research on the type of patients that I shake hands with in clinic. So it's really relevant to me, because when I'm finding some new paradigm in the lab or asking some new question, it's really driven by how can I take better care of my patients, what are the questions they're asking me that I can't answer, and what are the things that my lab can bring to the bedside of the patient that can hopefully improve their outcomes. I think it is a challenge for students who are interested in science to master the amount of information that they're given in high school and in college before you can even get to that point where you can ask the right questions. And so some of that love of investigation that you get to really explore when you're in graduate school and your postdoctoral fellowship and in your career, you don't really come to when you're in the early stages of deciding what you want to do. The two biggest pieces of advice I give to young people who are interested in science is, number one, study everything and find the thing that you really love, because careers in science can be all-encompassing. You really have to dig in with a passion. It's not something you can do because your mother thinks you should, or your best friend is doing, or because you don't know what you want to do with your life. You have to really jump in with both feet, and don't be afraid to ask questions. If something doesn't make sense to you, it's either not correct or it's not being explained properly. And I always say, if you can't explain what you're doing to a five-year-old, then you don't know what you're doing. And if someone can't explain it to you, seek out someone who can, because there's nothing magic about science. It just takes a lot of focus.